Tag teams that can make a major impact on today's WWE, I absolutely think of these two teams. Ouch. Interlock applied. Oh, no, no. Uh-oh. Members of the WWE Universe and the WWE locker room have felt that tag team matches should have two referees. One referee is in the ring overseeing the action, and the other is located out on the floor, making sure teams follow the rules and do not engage in potentially damaging behavior. I think it's a good idea, something perhaps Mr. McMahon might want to consider. Point that people have been talking about for years, and that's a second referee being thrown into tag team matches. I remember WWE Hall of Famer and former WWE President Gorilla Monsoon used to express a strong advocacy for two referees being appointed to tag team matches. It's something that's been talked about for decades, Michael. I don't think it's ever going to happen. We've seen it on occasion, but I think it's best to let the superstars be responsible for themselves. And the appointed official for the match needs to do the job they're paid to do. I don't think it's that much to ask. During the rivalry between the Hardy Boys and Cesaro and Sheamus over the Raw Tag Team Championship, the teams became very familiar with one another. In June of 2017, the teams met in a 2-out-of-3 fall on Monday Night Raw. The most important fall in a 2-out-of-3 falls contest is the first fall. If a team can win the first fall, that sets the tone for the rest of the match, and your opponents are playing catch-up. The 2-out-of-3 falls match you saw the Hardy Boys go at it with Cesaro and Sheamus was a throwback of sorts. Throughout the 1960s and 70s, championship title defenses and grudge matches were often decided with a 2-out-of-3 falls score. Cesaro and Sheamus didn't waste any time and scored the decisive first fall after a brogue kick rocked Jeff Hardy. Cesaro and Sheamus wanted to continue their domination of Team Extreme, but the Hardys had other ideas as Matt tied things up at one fall apiece with a twist of fate on the Swiss sideboard. After a swanton bomb by Jeff Hardy, the match broke down, and the third fall was ruled a double countout. In order to be a premier tag team, a superstar and their teammate must have that continuity where they're a well-oiled machine inside the ring. I'm talking about classic techniques, like cutting the ring in half, isolating your opponent, relegating them to your corner, and making frequent tags so that the fresh man is always in the ring. That's how you keep your opponents off balance. And set him up. Nail it. Corey, a few moments ago, you took us through what it takes for a tag team to be successful. The continuity between tag team partners is crucial. When a team is able to keep one opponent in the ring for an extended period of time without making a tag, they're able to focus their attack on one individual and one body part. And that's when things really start to take shape if you're on the tag team that's in control of the match. When you look at the tag teams who dominated this business, all of them worked well together as a unit and were able to keep an opponent in the ring long enough to make that adversary the focal point of their assault. In May of 2017, SmackDown Live saw an incredible women's tag team match when Charlotte Flair and Becky Lynch squared off against welcoming committee members Natalya and Carmella. The rivalry between these women got so intense that Naomi was in Flair and Lynch's corner, and Tamina was in Natalya and Carmella's corner. Back inside the ring now. I think only a group as treacherous as the welcoming committee could bring Becky Lynch and Charlotte Flair back together. Natalya's power set the tone for the match and gave her team an advantage. That was until Carmella's overconfidence let the Irish last kick return the tide and get back into the match. And then it was elementary from there for the Irish-born superstar. Naomi did an excellent job of making sure any quote-unquote committee nonsense cost her girls the match. Once Becky Lynch got Carmella locked in the disarmer, there was nothing for the Staten Island Princess to do but to tap out. And it didn't take long for that to happen. Incoming! Roper. He might have it. Victory is on the horizon. And he's heading back in. Nakamura in off the tag. Pop slam down hard. Ooh. If I was Shinsuke, I'd rein in the antics a little bit. Hope he can keep this kind of effort going. That's how you wear down your opponent. Tying up the legs now. Oh, look at the surfboard! This might be it! Oh, my! Tying up the legs now. Oh, look at the surfboard! Oh, my goodness, this hurts! Oh! He has him right where he wants him. He's teetering on the edge here. Missile drop kick with the target. So precise. Took it off the knee. Jaw shattering boot. And this guy's on. Look out. To see Carl and turn things around quickly to remain in this thing. I don't think this is how I envision this match going here tonight.
This is not the time to be a hero. To keep this match from slipping away, he needs to get his partner in there and take a break.
Oh, what incredible power. Wow, what a vertical suplex. Knee drop.
That was nasty, so precise.
Two. He's thinking of Nakamura making a spectacle of himself.
Beautiful technique. Hooked up. Inverted suplex.
I'll tell you right now, any kick from Nakamura can turn your lights out in an instant. But his finisher, the Kinshasa, could put your lights out for good. Nakamura's knees should be registered as lethal weapons.
Uh-oh, he's in trouble here.
He's looking shaky. This could be the end.
Yeah, let's hope he can keep this kind of effort going.
He's almost got it.
Anyone who knows anything about Shinsuke Nakamura.
The King of Strong Style with a massive slam.
Shinsuke Nakamura.
Wow, I'm just as surprised as you guys are.
So much for Nakamura being reserved.
A knee right to the face.
That knee is a lethal weapon.
Vicious knee.
He's lining him up.
Here we go. Kinshasa!
Hold it, Michael. Shinsuke Nakamura called himself the artist, and it's plain to see why. From his theatrical entrance to his unorthodox movement in the ring, almost everything about Nakamura could be put in a museum.
Well, except for his cheap shot low blows.
Hooked up and belly of that suplex.
Going back to the artist known as is Shinsuke Nakamura. We've also seen many of the masterpieces in the ring from Nakamura during his time in NXT and on SmackDown Live. Unfortunately, he's tarnished that reputation by resorting to cheap tactics nowadays.
Look, he's still an artist in my eyes, an American hero. He also has the best entrance wardrobe in WWE. That actually means something. I mean, to the most well-dressed guy at ringside.
In a tag team contest, a superstar and partner walk up against another duo. Unless there's a special stipulation added to the match, the traditional rules of a singles match apply in terms of winning the match via pinfall, submission, countout, or disqualification.
In a standard tag, he's got the shoulders down.
Too close for cover. Can you believe what he's missed doing here tonight?
Well, the head misses a body. Oh, man, that's just nasty.
He's making a statement here with this attack.
Superstars in action. Hope everybody at home set those DVRs, because that was a match you're going to want to watch again and again and again. Epic. This entire match was just one big highlight reel.
Here,
and I didn't expect anything else.
Daniel Bryan and Shinsuke Nakamura.
And that's a nice win for these two here tonight. I can honestly say that a win is a little...
is underway, and in this one, I wouldn't attempt to predict what's going to happen. I'd just be willing for anything. Sometimes that's all you can do. We've seen some amazing ladder matches over the years, and I'm willing to bet this one will rank right up there with some of the best.
Better be careful not to get this qualified.
As you may remember, Kurt Angle actually fired Braun Strowman back in January of 2018. And guys, I can't help but wonder how different the WWE landscape would be if that firing actually stuck.
Superstars who wished it stuck. Kane and Braun immediately come to mind, considering what he did to them at the Royal Rumble and WrestleMania respectively. Nature League with his qualification.
Yeah. Of course, we all recognize Braun Strowman as a legitimate main eventer, but remember, guys, it wasn't that long ago that he was considered the black sheep of the Wyatt family.
He's setting up the ladder now.
Well, can he get up there in time? That's the question.
Climbing up, guys. Here we go.
Oh, boy.
He's heading for higher ground.
To get away from you.
I guess he... Here we go with this, man.
It's not uncommon for superstars to practice a little hyperbole when it comes to nicknames. For example, King Kong Bundy isn't really a walking condominium, but when it comes to Braun Strowman, there's no more fitting moniker than the Monster Among Men.
So it's kind of like when they call you Jake Jr., right?
I've never heard that one.
The superstars in this one got after it pretty good from the opening bell. Can't complain about the effort, technical proficiency, or result here.
Here is your winner, the Big Boss Man.
Well, that one was over before it even started.
Wow. We just saw a monster player strike right before our very eyes.
Boy, I don't think we're going to have too many disappointed viewers at home. Not with action like we just saw.
Seeing here with him. This thing appears to be slipping away from him in a hurry, guys, and you can bet he envisioned things going much differently for him heading into this match.
There are two things to remember about Baron Corbin's end of days. One,
entry number four. Who's it gonna be?
Things are about to get interesting now.
You can say that again.
such an impressive finishing maneuver and delivers incredible impact. Here,
and that's an elimination.
2017 Royal Rumble saw more than 52,000 members of the WWE Universe go to the Alamo Dome in San Antonio, Texas. It was one of the most exciting Rumble matches in recent memory. And I couldn't help but notice the amount of WWE superstars who were first NXT superstars who've now made an impact during one of the biggest events in WWE.
Well, it looks like The Rock is going to get involved with this.
Ooh-wee.
Next entrance getting ready to come out. Oh, the clothesline.
Forcefully delivered. It's Rollins, Seth Rollins. It was rumored all day he was in the building.
Nice job getting out of trouble there.
Talk about a great escape.
There's the elimination.
Truth. And as always, little Jimmy's right by his side. Someone's got to get Guy.
Wow, somehow escapes trouble.
I don't know how you messed that one up.
That was a certain elimination.
He's got the elimination code. What took him so long? When we look at the prestige of winning the Royal Rumble match and how the event itself puts the world on the road to WrestleMania, we must go back to the success of the first Royal Rumble. The match started off with two future WWE Hall of Famers in Bret Hitman Hart and Tito Santana. And every 2 minutes thereafter saw an incredible list of superstars enter the match.
Byron, look who we have here.
This changes the entire complexion of this match.
Beautiful. That's an elimination.
Championship, Reigns had to outlast 29,
and that's elimination right there, guys, with an exclamation point, no less. Look out, this changes things big time.
A fresh superstar usually does, Cole.
Boom, impact. Yes, it's Drew McIntyre.
Successful third-generation wrestler in WWE history. The Orton family has been a fixture in wrestling for over 30 years. What took him so long?
Oh, nasty impact. Now, this shakes things up a bit, to say the least.
Secondly, Finn Balor is among the most charismatic superstars around, period.
Oh, and you can tell he's got evil intentions on his mind.
In a match like this, you have to, Michael.
Take into consideration when you're in there against Sin Cara is the loop.
And now it's number 21.
Triple H would all agree. Of course, those three are Royal Rumble matches after entering at the number 30. Whatever. The 1995 Shawn Michaels would laugh at that notion. And gets it. Number 24 has a good chance of winning this, guys.
I know. That's what 24 is my pick.
Second and disastrous. Here, guys, with an exclamation. case in point, no less.
Team Carl beginning to breathe a little heavy now. We can watch a Royal Rumble match without mentioning the mastermind behind the epic event. Of course, that person is WWE Hall of Famer.
I think I know who it is.
That's astute. Nobody controls the pace of the match.
Did you get this?
Heading to the ring with a purpose. Boy, that's the truth.
Oh, what a great escape.
Here's the elimination for
it. It took him so long.
Reflecting a bit more on Pat Patterson creating the Rumble, I can tell you that the concept wasn't initially working with Jay Cutler. And then there was one. There's your Rumble winner.
Here's your winner, Team Dream.
What an amazing finish to what may have been one of the most exciting Royal Rumble matches I've seen in years. So once again, like we just saw here.